Want to download and use resource packs in Minecraft? Well, that's what I'll show you in today's video. If you know what resource pack you want to download, feel free to skip to this segment of the video. For those who don't know what resource pack to use, Planet Minecraft, Modrinth, and CurseForge offer an assortment of resource packs to choose from. For this video, I'm going to find a resource pack on Planet Minecraft. So, I'll search for Planet Minecraft and click the link that would take you to planetminecraft.com. Planet Minecraft offers a huge array of community-made content for Minecraft, be it custom skins, mods, maps, and resource packs. Hover over the Minecraft button at the top and click Texture Packs. Texture packs are mostly the same as resource packs, and the name can pretty much be used interchangeably. On the texture pack page, you can narrow your search to better find what you're looking for. You can search for the type of resource pack, be it simplistic, themed, or more. Resolutions determine what the texture resolution will be for the pack, and you can filter to what areas a resource pack will affect, from just a mob or item, to the entire game. For me, I'm going to narrow my search to find a 64-bit resolution texture pack. So, I found the texture pack I'm going to download. This is Kumail's Gourmet Food Add-on Texture Pack, which retextures all the food items in-game to be a bit more stylish. Now, download the texture pack. Now that it's done, go ahead and launch Minecraft. Once you're loaded in, we can now bring the resource pack into the game. Navigate to the options, select resource packs, and inside, you can view all your resource packs you've got, as well as which ones are currently loaded. By default, you'll probably have either the default or Japa look, or the programmer art, which is the old textures from 1.13 and below. To get our resource pack in, open the resource pack folder. Now, drag your downloaded resource pack into this folder, and it should now be in your list in-game. To get it active, hover over the resource pack and click the arrow, which will now make it active in your game. If you're playing on an older or newer version of the game than what your resource pack is, the game will warn you about using it, as it may not work properly if loaded. Every resource pack will react differently, as some resource packs won't be affected if they're loaded in newer or older versions, whilst other resource packs may be affected significantly. If your chosen resource pack does get affected, either change your game or resource pack version to match. Press done. Load your world up. And there you have it. Other resource packs may require an additional process to install. For another example, I will download the Whimscape texture pack, retexturing the game with a crisp, vibrant art style. If we scroll down, you'll notice Whimscape features a Bushy Leaves add-on and has a patch for fresh animations if you use it. Scrolling down further, you'll see this texture pack requires Optifine or alternatives. Many texture packs will require Optifine for connected, varied, or a mix of textures, custom models, or item textures. To keep things simple, I'm going to use Optifine for this video, though if you want to use an alternative to Optifine, let me know in the comments. Now, let's download the pack. This will take you to the CurseForge page, where you can download the pack from there. If you haven't installed Optifine yet, do so first before proceeding with the video. If you're unsure about how to download Optifine, this video here should help you out. With the pack downloaded, load your instance of Minecraft that contains Optifine. Now, navigate to your resource pack folder as normal. Drag your downloaded pack in and load it in-game. Before we test if this works, head into the video settings, select quality, and make sure all these buttons are turned on. These are what allow texture packs to have custom and varied textures and models. To check if it's working, find a specific thing from your chosen resource pack that has varied textures or models. With Whimscape, a good way to test if it works is to view the enchanted books. If each one has a different color and marking on it, then you're good. If they're all the same color, make sure Optifine is installed and your settings are all correct. With our final example, I'm going to download Spryzing's Better Glint, which allows you to change the color of the enchantment glint on enchanted items. Search up Minecraft Better Glint, and on the search, you should find these three web domains. Either of these will do, but I'm going to go into the CurseForge link. You can either scroll down to the right to select which version of Minecraft you want, or click the Files tab and refine your search from there. I'm going to download version 1.5 of the resource pack for 1.19.4. Now that's downloaded, bring it over to your resource pack folder. You will notice, however, that the resource pack isn't available to choose from when in-game. Why is that? Well, it's because this zip is the file that contains all the different color variants, and since we can only choose one at a time, we'll need to extract those out of the zipped file. To do that, double-click the zipped file and select the color variants folder. As you can see, this folder contains all the color versions available. Select all of them and drag them out into the resource pack folder. We can delete the original zip file, as it is no longer needed. Now, when we can go back into Minecraft, we could see all the glint options available. And that's how to download resource packs in Minecraft. And hopefully, you found this video helpful.